I have a big problem. We do barbecue. We do a lot of barbecue.
Do you guys ever?
Yes. And when we do barbecue, we need big gear. Lots of gear. And obviously, the odd time when there's a fire ban, we need to use propane mm-hmm. to do it. And one of the things I've discovered is my barbecue don't work on my motorhome and on the other cowboy's trailer. Yep. It doesn't connect.
That's really a common question we get today. A lot of the modern RVs today are coming with a quick connect. You have it recessed underneath there, a real easy quick connect that everyone wants to connect their barbecue to. Unfortunately, that isn't what it's made for.
So here's one here, and I like the fact that you're prompting me because I brought one of these babies around. But before we actually talk about the quick connect, and that's how quick you connect it. This is not high pressure propane. This is not the stuff you're going to use when you run a big barbecue.
That is the problem. When you have the quick connections on the back here, this is actually a low pressure gas. So what that means, it's gone through the regulator at the front of the trailer, and it's made the pressure in the system enough to run your fridge, furnace, stove. All those items are on lower pressure gas. What everyone tries to do is they want to take their Weber, they want to take their PortaChef, and they want to plug it into the quick connect here and, you know, use a propane on the RV. It's a reasonable request. Problem is, we already have low pressure gas, and then they want to connect a barbecue to it that has another regulator. It's not going to work. So a lot of people say, okay, I'm going to redneck it. Let's get rid of the regulator on the barbecue and we'll plug straight in. Well, what I need you to picture is cooking your beautiful T-bone steak or a nice cut of pork on the burner in your RV. We've got restricted. We only have so much pressure. Your RV is on 13 inches of pressure. Your average barbecue is running off of 21 to 26.
So let's make that practical. I know you get all numbery and interesting with all your gauges and stuff. The bottom line is there's not enough heat in your burner if you run it off a low pressure system.
You bet. That is the long and short of it is, I'd rather sell you my lighter to cook your steak.
So you can't redneck this thing, but there are barbecues that give you an option to, that's actually made for RVs, aren't there?
You betcha, it's a low pressure barbecue. And a lot of people say, oh, but I want a bigger barbecue. Well, no, the problem is we only have so much heat, so these RV barbecues are much smaller to keep that heat in. A very common one is you see a lot of the Aussie grills. You see the RVQ. Even Camco and Olympian have a couple of low pressure barbecues, but they're all smaller for a reason. We only have so many BTUs to work with when we are on low pressure gas, and that's why they're specific to the RV.
Those are really neat little things, even though I can't do a big barbecue on them.
You bet. They're really neat, they're really handy, and they're designed for portable stoves or RV barbecues. That's it.
And can I get it on the phone? Can I get it on the internet? Just help me out. How do I talk with you?
We would love to help you out. You can text us even at our main line. You can call, you can email. Stop in and see us. We'll show you what you need to get this on down the road. But when it comes to propane, make sure you talk to somebody who knows what they're talking about. There are lots of people that think they do, and there's lots of internet warriors out there. Make sure to talk to somebody that actually understands certification for an RV.